Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Here is a question from one of my YouTube subscribers. They want to know, in Microsoft Excel, how to separate positive and negative numbers that happen to be in the same column. This actually happens frequently when you download credit card statements, bank statements. Positive and negatives will be in the same column. So I listed some merchants in column A, I've got the amounts in column B, and in column C, I just threw in some dates, transaction dates. Column B is what we care about. I'm going to show you two ways to do this. One method is using an if statement, and I see this done a lot on YouTube. But I'm going to show you a second method that actually may just be even easier. But before we do that, I'd also want to show you how to count and figure out how many negative numbers or positive numbers you have in the column. So let's dive in right now. The very first thing I'm going to do is use a COUNTIF function to figure out how many negative numbers I have. I'm over in E2, it is COUNTIF. You select your range and two arguments for COUNTIF. Your criteria is less than zero. I'm going to do Control Enter to stay in this same cell. There's my function in the formula bar. I've got the number 9. Quick tip, if you want to include 0, then you do less than or equal to 0. Still got 9. I'm going to change B3 to 0. My count if went to 10. Undo just to get it back here. So there's that right there. I'm going to get rid of that. So now let's take a look at the two ways to separate the positive and negatives. I'm going to do what I consider the absolute easiest way first, and then I'll follow it up with a COUNTIF function. Here's what I would do. I would just simply right click and go to sort and sort smallest to largest. That'll put the negatives at the top right there. I'm going to add a column, so I'm going to insert. Just simply highlight the negatives and move them over and call this negative, call it deposit, call it withdrawals, whatever you'll do. To me, that was the easiest. Cool tip about that one, by the way. I know I don't have a lot of numbers. I'm going to undo a couple times. I got the blank column in here again. Let's say that the negative numbers go all the way down. I'm making this example up to cell Z. 285,000. That's where they go. I would do Control Z, 285,000. Hit OK, and I am in Z 285,000. Back to the top is Control Home. So if you're saying, well, Chris, you just jumped there, what are you going to do to select it? Here you go. I'm in cell B2, Control G. I need to select a cell B10. Hold down the shift key and then click OK. So I'm holding shift on the keyboard, click OK, and I just selected those. And here I go again with either cut and paste or just drag and drop. There you go. One last tip for you. I'm going to go back and sort by merchant before I do the if statement. One more tip for you. I'm back to sorting by the merchant. So I've got the negatives and the positive all together. One other item you could do is I'm in cell B2, I'm holding down the shift key, I'm going to double click on the bottom border, that will select them all. You could use conditional formatting less than zero also to highlight the negative numbers. And if you say, Chris, why don't you highlight the negative numbers? Right click on one of those and you're going to do a sort, put selected cell color on top. Just another way to sort them. That's all. Easy to see now also, by the way. Just get them, pull them over. All right, here we go with let me lose the conditional formatting. I'm gonna clear rules from entire sheet. I'm gonna go back and sort by the merchant. So here we go with the if statement, and this is gonna end this video. So I wanna leave column B exactly as it is. So I really need two columns in here. I don't care whether you do the positive or the negative numbers first. Let's just do one. Equal if, I'm going to say if cell B2 If B2 is less than zero, comma, the if statement has three arguments. In this example, all three are going to be required. If B2 is less than zero, what do you want to do? Well, I want to return B2, comma, what if B2 is not less than zero? I'm going to put in a blank right there. I should get 20 crosshairs, double click. That took care of the negative numbers, and here are the positives. It's actually just the opposite. Equals if B2 greater than or equal to zero. Because you want to make sure if something's zero, you pick it up. So I did less than zero for the negatives. I could have done less than or equal to. It's up to you how you want to do this. B2, comma, it's just the same function. There you go. If you want a cool tip, by the way, I'm going to end it with this. This is a cool tip. I could have right here copied and done a paste, but notice in my formula it's referencing C2 instead of B2. And I autofill down and I'm like, oh, I'm referencing C2 instead of B2. Control H is find and replace, but on the home tab, I'm on the home tab in the top left. Find and select, replace, that is exactly Control H. It even tells you that. What do you want to do? I want to find the letter C, replace it with the letter B. If you don't see your options, click options and it expands and collapse. It is going to pick this up in the formulas right here. So when I hit, I'm doing the math in my head. Header row is row one. I have 18 rows, so that's 17 records. I've got the cell reference listed twice in the cell. So 17 times 2 is 34. So when I hit replace all, I should get 34. All done. We made 34 replacements. And if you say, Chris, you got the exact same answer? Yeah, I just need to go and change the symbol. There you go. So that is find and replace. Just a tip, really had nothing to do with this. I could have just typed that one just as easily from scratch. But in a complex function, I have used that plenty of times. Feel free to subscribe. Let me know if you like this video. Great question from one of my YouTube subscribers. Ring the bell. Have a great day. Thank you.